Hello dear students, very good morning to you all. In today's class I teach you very simple topic named structure and union. You may get this question in VTU main examination. The question will be like this: write the differences between structure and union. Very simple topic. Okay, I explain you the five differences. Okay, first difference, second, third, fourth and five with example. I request you to listen to me with concentration. I explain you. Okay, let us start. Then what is the difference between structure and union? Already we know what is structure. Structure is user defined data type, user created data type. Means user means we are all programmers. We can create our own data type like int, float, char, double. Int is the data type created by developers. Float is the data type created by developers. Double is the data type created by developers of C language, C compiler. But we are the programmers, we can create our own data type also. That is what already you know. We create our own data type, that means we define one structure. What is structure? Structure is user defined data type. Then how to define structure? We use a struct keyword. Which keyword we use? Struct keyword. Look at this example. I am creating my own data type named struct temp. I am creating my own data type named struct temp, and it helps us to store character, as well as it helps us to store integer value. It helps us to store float type of value also. Means in single variable we store character also, in single variable we store integer value also, in single variable we store the floating point number also. That means struct temp is the data type created by us. T is the variable of which type? Struct temp. Struct temp is user defined data type, user created data type. Already you know about it. Then how to define structure? To define structure we use the struct keyword. Then what is union? Union is also user defined data type only. Structure and union both are same. Structure is also user created data type. Union is also user created data type. Look at this example. In this example I am using struct keyword. In this example I am using union keyword. And now T is the variable of which type? Union temp type. T is the variable of which type? Struct temp type. That means structure is also user created data type. Union is also user created data type. To define structure we use struct keyword. To define union we use union keyword. Both are same. To define structure we use struct keyword. To define union we use union keyword. Okay, now let us discuss, continue. Struct keyword helps us to define structure. Union keyword helps us to define union. This is the first difference. You write in lowercase only in exam. Don't write S capital, don't write U capital. These are keywords. Keywords we write in lowercase. And I request you to underline these two keywords in exam. Okay, no problem. I hope everyone has understood. What is the first difference between structure and union? Struct keyword we use to define structure. Union keyword we use to define union. Then structure is user defined or created data type. User means programmer defined or created data type. Union, union is also user created or defined data type. No problem at all. But very important difference is here. Structure will allocate separate memory for all its members. It is very interesting. But union will allocate common memory. Common memory for all its members. Structure allocates separate memory for its members. Union allocates common memory for all its members. Okay, see the example. First member is A, character type. Second member is B, integer type. Third member is C, float type. See the diagram of memory allocation. And this is the A member. This is the B member memory. This is the memory for C member. A member is of which type? Character type. As you know already, character will take 1 byte. 1 byte is allocated. For A member, and integer will take usually 2 bytes. For B data member, for member it has taken 2 bytes. For third member it has taken 4 bytes. Float will take 4 bytes, integer will take 2 bytes, character will take 1 byte. This is just I have shown you the addresses. Assume 1 byte means 1 memory. Address of that memory is 8000. Let us assume address to store integer values we need 2 memories, 1 byte and 1 byte, 2 bytes. If the memory of first address is 8000, what will be the memory of next address? 8001. 2 bytes, no? 8001 and 8002 for B data member, 2 bytes. Then for C member, 4 bytes. Address is 8003 means we need 4 memories. Then what will be the address of first memory? 8003, 8004, 8005, 8006. Let us assume like that. Okay. That means character takes 1 byte, integer takes 2 bytes, float takes 4 bytes. Don't forget to draw this diagram in examination. Not only like this, you can draw the diagram in your own way. But don't forget to show 1 byte for A, 2 bytes for B, 4 bytes for C. Show like this. Evaluator will be happy, you get good marks. Total memory occupied by T variable. T is the variable now. Total memory occupied by T variable is 1 plus 2 plus 4, 4 plus 2, 6 plus 1, 7 bytes. Total memory occupied by the T variable is 7 bytes. That means structure will allocate separate memory for its member. But union will not allocate separate memory for all the members. It allocates common memory. And how many bytes it takes, do you know? It takes just 4 bytes. Character requires 1 byte. Integer requires 2 bytes. Float requires 4 bytes. Which member will take more memory? Whether character member will take more memory or integer will take more memory or float will take more memory, can you tell me? Float will take more memory. That means it allocates 4 bytes. See here, 8000, 8001, 8002, 8003. Addresses are 4, 4 memories are there. And union temp T. T is the variable of which type? Union temp. Memory allocated for the T variable is just 4 bytes. But here, programmer can work with only one member. It is very important difference. Here programmer can use all its members at once. Programmer can use all the members at once. But here programmer can use or work with one of the member. If you are working with A, at the time no need, we are not working with B and C. If I am using B, I will not use A and C. If I am using C, I will not use A and B. Only in that situation only we use union. Now you are the software developer, you are the programmer, you only decide while solving problem. If you are the programmer, if you want to work with all the members, then go for structure. No sir, I want to work with any one of the member at once. Oh, you want to work any one of the member, you want to work with any one of the member, then don't go for structure, go for union. This is very important difference. Programmers can use or programmers can work with one of the member, not all at once. But here programmers can work with all its members. This is what the major difference between structure and union. That's why this union has allocated just 4 bytes. Now if you are working with A member, in A member I store K. Means just we are using 1 byte. Remaining 3 bytes are wasted. If you are working with B member, I want to store 700. Then I am using 2 bytes, 8000 and 8001. Remaining 2 bytes are wasted. If you are working with float type, we use all the 4 memories. Then I hope everyone has understood. If you are, at what time we have to use union? If you want to work with one of the member, if you want to store K, don't use other members. If you want to store 700, don't use remaining 2. If you want to store this value, don't use the remaining. That means union means what programmers can use one of the member at once. I hope everyone has understood. Then now can you tell me the difference between structure and union? Struct keyword is used to define structure. union keyword is used to define union. It is also user defined data type. It is also user defined data type. It allocates separate memory for all its members. It allocates common memory for all its members. Programmers can use all its members at once, but programmers cannot use all its members. Programmers can use only one member at once. You can elaborate more in the exam. Don't forget to give example. Struct temp with three members, union temp with three members. Define the variable of struct temp, define the variable of union temp, and I am using all the members here. I stored k, I stored 700, I stored 100 rupees 50 paise. I have shown the diagram, I have shown the total number of bytes also. And here, but see here, I am working with one of the member. Just I am storing k here, I am printing the t dot a, I am getting k output. Just like this it is stored and we are fetching it. We retrieve and we print. And I am trying to work with second member and I am printing here and I am getting the output also. This is what the third. Total memory occupied by the variable t is 4 bytes. If you write like this in exam, definitely you get good marks. Now practically I will run the program and I will show you. Okay, let us start the C software, Turbo C++. Double click on that. You need to wait for few seconds. Software starts, then already you know how to work with Turbo C++. You get the editor. Now you have to close all the open files. Go for window menu. Alt W is for window menu, then close all. All files will be closed. Go for file menu. Alt F, new. How to maximize it? Alt W, then go for zoom. Okay, maximized. Hash include, then std io dot h, afterwards find, then main. Here my program started, here my program completed. Okay, you can save it, file menu and save, and structure and union dot c. okay, then I create union directly, union temp. Okay, union name is temp. Here my union structure definition started, here completed, semicolon, syntax. First member, character type, member name is A. Second one is integer type, member name is B. Third type of float, member name is C. Then I defined the union. Now you have to define the variable, union temp t. Okay, I have defined the variable. Get ch means we wait. Okay, now let us run the program. File, save, run menu. Union is defined, memory is allocated. No output, get ch, machine is waiting. Now I want to check the memory allocated by t variable. I hope everyone knows. Printf, printf, slash n means cursor comes down. Memory occupied by t variable is percentage d bytes. How to know the memory occupied by t variable? Which operator we use? Size of in bracket t. We get memory allocated by t variable. Let us run the program. See, memory occupied by t variable is 4 bytes, means it has taken 4 bytes. Okay, now instead of union, make it as struct, and here you can make it as struct. Okay, struct, and size of t. Okay, now run it. 7 bytes. Okay, structure is taking 7 bytes. I have not cleared the screen. You can clear the screen. CLR, SCR, it clears and it prints. You can run it. Memory occupied by t variable is 7 bytes because it is structure. Instead of struct, if you make it as a union, it allocates memory for only the large data member. Just I write union, then run the program. 4 bytes. Now you can work with only one member at once. What I do? I go for t dot a equals to in single quote k. K I stored. then I go for printf, then slash n means cursor comes down, t dot a equals to percentage c, okay, t dot a, whatever is there in t dot a, that will be displayed. Now k is displayed, but I am working with only one. I will copy it, shift and down arrow, go for edit menu, go for copy, edit and paste, then edit and paste, then edit and paste, okay. Control KH is for unselect, okay. Control KH. Now what I do, t dot b, t dot b is integer type, I store 700, t dot b is 700. Now I print it, t dot b, that is integer type, so you have to type d, then member name is b, then last one t dot c, t dot c is for floating point number, I store the floating point number, 100 rupees 50 paise, then we have to use percentage f, okay. You can take data member or you can take any other text message also. I go for t.c, but lastly what I do, control y is for deleting line, I want to print all, t.a equals to percentage c, t.b equals to percentage d, t.c equals to percentage f, now t.a comma t.b, t.b comma t.c. But here, but union means we can work with only one member at once. I stored one value, I am printing, I get k. I am storing 700, I am printing, I get 700. I am trying to store 150 and I am printing, I get. But here I am trying to fetch all, not possible. That means what will be the output for this instruction? Can you guess? We get the lastly stored value, means we get 150. We are not able to display all the three at once. Okay, let us run the program. See here, t dot a is k, yes, t dot b is 700, t dot c is 0.00. oh, where is the mistake? T dot c, t dot c, oh, I have not modified the member name here, t dot c, save it, run. Okay, t dot c, but see the last printf, t dot a nothing, t dot b 0, t dot c 100.50, means last member is working. Which one is working? Last member is working. And if the question is there for more marks, why can't you write such programs? If you write such programs and as an example, Velometer will not detect your marks at all. Like this, you need to prepare for exams. I hope everyone has understood. Okay, I request you to watch it again if you won't understand. And you can share this video with your other friends also. You can comment. Okay, thank you one and all. Have a nice day.